Today we are going to start an interesting topic in irrigation and bridge drawing. That is the previous 8 sessions we are completed irrigation drawing. Now we will start bridge drawing. In this bridge drawing we are having in culverts and T-beam bridges. Culverts are the small openings provided to allow the stream water from upstream side to downstream side, or even culvert may be used as in grade separators, allowing in road below and a rail on the top, or road may be top as well as below the culvert. There are the three types of culvert. One is slab culvert. In slab we can use road and rail, or waterway and road, like that. Another culvert is box culvert, that is most common in the city areas. Third one is pipe culvert. In pipe culvert we will allow the water to flow through the pipe, and above there may be road or rail. In this session we will take up slab culvert with single span slab culvert with splayed wing valve. Next session we will take up two span slab culvert with return wing valve. This is the problem I have taken from the examination problems, previous year examination problems. Following are the details of single span slab culvert, RCC slab culvert, proposed across a stream. Average width of stream 6 meter, span is 5 meter. Bank slope 1:1, bed level of the stream is given 100.00, HFL 102.00, ground level 101.50, road formation level is 103.00, hard rock level is taken at 98.5, road width is 5 meter, footpath on either side is given 1 meter, curb is 10 cm thick, thickness of RCC slab 0.3 meter, thickness of bearing coat 0.1 meter, bearing slab on abutment and pier, here pier it is not there because it is a single span, only abutments will be there, that is 0.3 meter. Top width of abutment 1.0 meter. Back batter, front face is vertical, it is 1:8. Parapet wall 300 mm thick, 0.8 meter height. These are the data given in which you may think a lot of information which may be new to all. That is why my request is first you write down this problem before moving to the next slides in a sheet of paper, so that wherever I am discussing this each and every RL as well as dimensions, you can easily understand where it is actually positioned in the drawing. Guard stone 0.7 meter high, 2 meter into 0.2 meter at 1 meter center to center. Size of the guard stone is 0.2 meter into 0.2 meter. Wing wall splayed type. Top width is taken as in 0.5 meter. Front face is vertical. This is splayed type wing wall we are going to discuss. Provide protection works both on upstream side and downstream side. We have to provide the rough stone revetment. Assume any other data. Draw to a scale 1:50 the following views. Two views they asked, half longitudinal elevation and half longitudinal section, half plan at top and half plan at bottom. This is the 50 marks compulsory question in examination. Let us see how to draw this drawing step by step. Before moving to drawing, let us see some basics. This is the return wing wall, which is we are going to discuss in next class. In written wing wall, this will be the abutment. This is the abutment portion. This is the written wing walls. These are the two written wing walls. In between this box, we are going to fill the earth to bring the road level. Bring the road level approach. Approach portion we are going to fill so that we will match the road level to the bridge level. Because this is perpendicular to this return wing wall is always perpendicular to abutment. In case of splayed wing wall, this is the abutment portion. These two are the splayed wing walls with written here, written wall. Okay, this splayed wing wall will be sloping in this direction as well as in this direction. Here also it is sloping in this direction as well as in this direction. This abutment is sloping this side, earth side, and another side, water face, it is a vertical. Here earth will be filled in this portion, and also earth is filled in sloped way. Okay, it will give an economy instead of making a box. When the earth is having a stability, it is a good earth is available, then we can go for the splayed wing wall. This is the model what I have taken from our laboratory, what we are having in model in our polytechnic. This is very old model. It has been kept several years. It is used for our civil engineering examination. Very good. You can easily understand from this model. This is the bed width of the stream or canal. Okay, in this bed width we are going to construct the bridge or culvert. Here it may be here abutment, here one more abutment. This abutment is constructed from up to this end, up to road width. Central one pier is there because it is a two span culvert. And this is the wing wall, splayed wing wall. It is splayed in this direction also, it's sloping. Here also it's sloping. And this is the return portion of the splayed wing wall. Here earth is filled both side to bring the road level to the level of bridge or culvert. Here it is the approach. This may be canal or road. On the top, below, stream or river is flowing. Okay, this is the cut water. Water will be water splits here. When it is moving here, it splits and passes through this opening. This is the structure, and of course these are the parapet walls provided on both sides. Okay, and of course road width is reduced, road width or canal width is reduced in this portion so that cost of the bridge or culvert should be minimum. For that purpose it is reduced. This is an actual model. It is not a model, it is actually constructed in the field. You can observe here, this is the box culvert with central pier. These are the splayed wing walls. This is the abutment portion. Again, that side also splayed wing wall. Here earth is filled to make the level. The function of this abutment as well as wing wall is to retain the earth so that it can give the clear space clear space for the water to enter through the culvert or bridge, and it should come out smoothly after passing through the bridge. This is about the few basics. Of course, you can study the bridge engineering, you can get an elaborate idea about the wing walls as well as abutment and what are the different types of culverts, bridges and all. Let us straight away start the drawing. Single span slab culvert with splayed wing wall. We are going to draw half longitudinal elevation, half longitudinal section. For this purpose, I have drawn one center line which will divide two sections, half longitudinal elevation left side and right side half longitudinal section. First, draw bed width 6 meter at RL 100.00 and then 1:1 slope, bank slope, and then ground level 101.50. This is the first step. You have to draw the bed width and the side slopes and then ground level. Right side, I have shown dotted line because these are the hidden lines which may not be visible when we cut through the abutment. Next, I have drawn RL of road formation level, RFL, road formation level 103.00. Then mark HFL 102.00 and cut some portion, or even afterwards you can show the cut portion after drawing wing wall and all. Of course, I have shown the hard rock level 99.00 below the bed level. Then from the center, 2.5 left side, 2.5 right side, draw one vertical line on left side as well as one more vertical line on right side. This is the span 5 meter. Left side, whatever you are drawn, it should touch up to the road formation level because it is a elevation. We can see complete height. Here I have left some portion for the RCC slab bearing. It is given in the problem. RCC slab should sit 0.3 meter on the abutment. Then make a point, mark one point a distance of 2.3 meter up to where we have to draw the wing wall. Okay, how it is 2.3 meter? It is the 1.5 h, 1.5 h. 1.5 is the thumb rule, h is the height of the wing wall from the ground level to road formation level. That is 103 minus 101.5, 1.5 meter it is height, 1.5 meter into 1.5. that may be around 2.25, that is round it up to 2.3 meter. Okay, in case of a return wing wall, we will take height from the bed level or up to the top of the concrete bed level into 1.5 h. in case of spared wing wall, we can take ground level minus road formation level. It is the thumb rule. 2.3 meter from the face of abutment, mark one point here at a distance of 2.3 meter. Then draw return wing wall, return portion of the wing wall, for a distance of 1.5 meter you can assume, and height 0.5 meter. Next, draw this line joining this top portion to the edge of the return wing wall, return portion of the wing wall, and here you mark 102.6 meter, which is below this road formation level. Why I marked 102.6 meter? It is the bottom of the RCC slab. Here slab is coming, slab bottom is 102.60. How it is? 103 meter is the road formation level. Wearing coat is given in the problem, 0.1 meter, which is provided here. And then thickness of RCC slab is given, 0.3 meter. 0.3 plus 0.1, 0.4 meter. 103 minus 0.4 meter, it is 102.6. I am leaving space of 0.4 meter above this abutment to accommodate the wearing coat as well as RCC slab. That means I have started this side drawing. I mean, we have completed the half longitudinal elevation. Very simple. But a little bit work is there. We have to show the slope here, and we have to join the line, that is top width of the wing wall. This we can draw after drawing the plan. Or approximately you can mark 0.5 meter here, and you can join, and then you can show the slope here, 1.5:1 slope. Whatever the level you are marked here, 102.6, top width of the abutment should be marked. This is the top width of the abutment. Then take batter of 1:8, it is given in the problem. 1:8, 1 horizontal, 8 vertical. Mark the point and join this line. You will get the inclination batter of 1:8. Then mark this bottom width. You can measure this bottom width after drawing. You show this hidden line. Same mirror. Then we have to draw foundation details. Foundation, you can assume, you can observe here, hard rock level is 99, bed level is 100, There is 1 meter difference between the hard rock level and bed level. I assumed 60 centimeter thick concrete bed, then balance 40 centimeter as a footing. One step footing we are provided and bed concrete is provided. If it is given in the problem, you can provide accordingly. Otherwise, you can assume one step or two step depending upon the depth of the foundation, that is depending upon the hard rock level. Here this offsets, concrete offsets, side offsets, you can assume 15 centimeter, normally 15 or 20 centimeter. Of course, if it is a foundation depth is more, then you can assume 30 centimeter offsets. Next, you can draw 30 centimeter thick RCC slab. This 30 centimeter thick RCC slab, here we have taken bearing of 30 centimeter. It should transfer the load from this bearing to the abutment. If bearing is not given, you can provide the up to end of the abutment. In problem it is given, that is why I have taken 30 centimeter bearing. If you zoom, you can observe, this is the 30 centimeter thick RCC slab. We have taken this portion bearing and I have shown some reinforcement details. It is not asked in the question paper. Sometimes they may give the details you have to show, that may carry 1 or 2 marks. Here straight away I assumed some reinforcement. If you don't have any idea, then just you fill the concrete, hatching by concrete, that's all. Not necessary to show the reinforcement details here. Actually we have to show, but examination point of view, if you don't have time, need not necessary to show the reinforcement details. Okay, this is the I have zoomed that portion. You can observe how detailing has been done. This is the overall view, and of course I have shown the 10 centimeter thick bearing coat. Whatever the balance portion here, it is the bearing coat. And also I extended same bearing coat dotted line this side also, which may not be visible. And also I have shown the dotted line here, that is the bearing of the slab on the abutment. That means here we cannot see the details since it is a front elevation. Actually there will be there is having an abutment similar way what is on the right side with the foundation details. Because it is elevation, we cannot see the details. And this side, this wing wall dotted line you can show, because it is cut through the abutment, we cannot see the wing wall. Wing wall is projected, that we cannot see when we cut through abutment. If time permits, you can show the hidden lines. And then parapet wall is given from here or end of this abutment you can start, and end of abutments you can stop. Height of the parapet wall is given as in 0.8 meter. 80 centimeter. In that I am assuming 0.1 meter as in coping. That means if you see the cross section of the wing wall, it looks like this. This is the top coping and this is the wing wall. We are viewing from this direction. We can observe this thickness of coping as well as height of the parapet wall. Show parapet wall, then show guard stones. Since it is given in the problem, show the guard stones 0.7 meter height, 1 meter center to center, up to certain distance. 1 meter center to center from this place to certain distance, and then can cut the portion of the road. And also in problem, they asked to show the rough stone pitching. When we cut here, you can see the rough stone pitching for the bed, and also rough stone pitching on the banks. Sorry, we have to show the rough stone pitching here. Here rough stone pitching may be there, that we cannot observe here front elevation. When you cut on the bank, near the bank, you can observe rough stone pitching side also. And also I have shown this guard stone, because when we view front, these are all visible. Has the drawing, because it is a cut section, has with the stone masonry symbol. Here concrete, here also concrete hatching, and here you can show the even wearing coat may be concrete or bitumen surface, that also you have to hatch. Normally it is a thin cement concrete provided as a wearing coat. Finally you can show these dotted lines. Similar fashion, hidden portion of the spread wing wall. This completes the half longitudinal elevation and half longitudinal section, which carries 25 marks. As I told you, you can complete this drawing straight away by drawing the slope and all. Here also this is wing wall is sloping, that is why it has shown sloped line. Here few more hidden lines I have shown, that is wearing coat as well as the slab thickness. Next our target is to draw the half plan at top, half plan at bottom. Half plan at top is very easy, because from top you can see only road, footpath, curb and parapet wall, and also wing walls. There's a few details of stone pitching. First you draw, this is extend from the top center line, and one more line draw as a center line. From this center line, take halfway this side and halfway this side. Road 5 meter wide, it is given in the problem, 5 meter wide road, and then this is the curb. When you see the cross section here, if you cut and see here, center portion will be road, and there will be footpath on both sides, then there is parapet wall. This is the parapet wall. It will be like this. Okay, and here curb is there. This is 10 centimeter curb. This is the road width 5 meter. This is again curb, and this is the footpath. These are the parapet wall. When you view from the top, you can see all details. Top width of the parapet wall, footpath, as well as curb, road, again curb, again footpath, again parapet wall. That is what I have shown here. First 5 meter wide road and then curb, then 1 meter footpath, and one more thing we have to draw, parapet wall. Parapet wall. Show the details, dimension it properly. Parapet wall thickness is 0.3 meter, footpath is 1 meter, curb is 0.1 meter. Okay. These are the details shown. Next step is to project these points. This point and this point. That is a 2.3 meter wing wall portion we have to project. And also we have to project this abutment portion where it starts and bottom width of the abutment. That means from the center line, here it is 2.5 meter. 5 meter span is there, 2.5 meter you have to mark. Okay, that's all. From here, from the top plan, we are projecting. Even this drawing is not there, just you can mark the 2.5 meter with this center line and mark this side, say 2.5 meter, 5 meter. You can start abutment here, and here you start the wing wall. From wing wall, we know the calculation 2.3 meter. Mark that and then draw that 45 degree line. It's not necessary you should draw this half longitudinal elevation and half longitudinal section, then only you can complete half line at top and half line at bottom. If you feel easy, you can complete this portion first and then you can start this. Okay, now let us concentrate half line at top and half line at bottom. Draw 45 degree line and then return 1.5 meter. 0.5 meter is the top width of the wing wall and return wall given in the problem. Complete this drawing. This is the one portion of the splayed wing wall. Similarly, complete another portion by marking the line here to here, and do similar way what you did in this portion. That means both should have similarities. It should not be bigger size and it is smaller size. I have seen some students, they will do some magic, I don't know. This wing wall will be bigger and this wing wall is smaller. It should be mirror. Then of course you can join up to the where you have shown the cut on the top. And don't worry, this line is this is the sloping line. This line is sloping line. It is not a wing wall line. By mistake I had drawn earlier. We can complete afterwards. See, this is sloping line. It slopes. We have to show the sloping line. And this, and another side also you have to show the sloping line. And remove all these projected lines and all. These projected lines also you have to remove. This completes almost half line at the top. From the top you can see the earth slope and road details. And earth slope on the another side. And a few more details we have to show. That is rough stone pitching. I assumed rough stone pitching up to 5 meter. This is the, see, if you see cross section of the stream, this line is this line, this one. And this is the sloping portion of the bank. And this portion is the horizontal portion of the bed. I assumed a 5 meter rough stone pitching and shown the slope. You can observe slope is in this direction because bed is like this. We have to show the slope in this direction. stone pitching. I have shown the stone pitching here. Similar way, I have completed this side also. Rough stone pitching as well as bed slopes. This means we have completed 100% half plan at the top. This carries 12.5 marks if it is a 50 marks question. 25 marks for half longitudinal elevation and half longitudinal section. Another 12.5 marks for the half plan at top. Next, I have marked the 2.5 meter, that is abutment line. This is the abutment line, or you can project from the whatever the view already drawn. Then 45 degree inclined wing walls. There are the four wing walls we can see from the top. These are the two, these are the two. Two for the upstream side, two for the downstream side. If we assume this is the upstream side, we are having in two wing walls. This is the downstream side. And this should be matched this level. Or if you get confused, you mark here 2.3 meter, 45 degree. Again, some students will write this side wing wall is bigger, very big. Very big wing wall will be there. Here, small wing wall. How it is, I don't know. You should follow the steps properly. And it is mirror. Both sides, it should be same. Then 1.5 meter horizontal return portion. 0.8 meter, I assume the bottom width of the wing wall. How it is bottom width of the wing wall? We have the RLF top of the abutment and also height of the wing wall. Height of the wing wall, how much we are having in height of the wing wall? This is 102.6. Okay, this is the RL is RL of ground level. What is the RL of ground level? RL of ground level is taken as an 100. 2.6 into we cannot make into 0.4 H you can use 0.4 H. But in this problem, they are given the back batter. Back batter is a 1 in 8. Therefore, this is the wing wall means top width is 0.5. Here top width is 0.5. Bottom width, if we project this line, this will be 0.5 plus this will be 0.5. Plus this additional portion we have to add. Additional portion means 1 by 8 into 2.6 is the height. That maybe comes around, I think, 0.3 meter, 2.7 or 3 meter something you may get. That if you add, you will get in 0.8 meter. We marked the 0.8 meter. Then at 90 degree to this line, here it is 0.8 meter. Here it is width of the bottom width of the abutment. Let us say bottom width of the abutment is B, what we measured. That length you have to take here. Similarly, draw this side also 90 degree. Here B, width is B. In this portion, width is B, bottom width of the abutment. here it is 0.8 meter. Draw horizontal line at width of 0.8 meter. Join these two lines, this point join. After joining, project this horizontal line, project this. It will meet some point here, that is the important for us. Balance all these construction lines we should remove. See, I have marked the two points. Again, another two points we have to mark. This is the spare wing wall portion. Okay. See, first project the bottom width. I told you this is the B. Width is B. This is the projected bottom width. Okay, this should be marked afterwards. Okay, this should be marked afterwards. When I am taken the projection itself, I have marked here. Then extend this. This line, if you extend this line, it will cut the inclined line, this portion. Okay, then remove all other construction lines. Previously, here two lines are there. What we joined, we got this point. Similarly, here two lines are there. What we joined, this portion. Mark that portions and then remove this construction line. This is the abutment portion. These are the spread wing wall portion. Remove all other construction lines. Then draw top width of the wing wall. Top width of the wing wall 0.5 meter. Abutment top width 1 meter. Like this, you have to show the abutment and then wing wall dotted line, hidden lines. Because it is half plan at bottom, these are all dotted lines. Next, you should draw projection of first footing. First footing projection completed. Next, projection of cement concrete, offsets of cement concrete, that you should complete. Finally, has the complete drawing. Because it's a cut section, you should hatch with a stone masonry symbol. Okay, this completes half plan at the bottom. This is half plan at top, this is half plan at the bottom. This is the overall sketch. You should produce in your drawing sheet, which will carry a 50 marks. Okay, take the snapshot of this and complete your drawing similar way. Okay, fine. We have completed single span slab culvert with splayed wing wall. My request to all viewers, first you go through the internet and search for some bridges which is having a bridge or culverts which is having in splayed wing walls in images or websites or PDF, and see how it is. If it is a splayed wing wall, how earths and all filled behind the wing wall and abutment, what are the component parts of the bridges, so that you can comfortably draw the details. Thank you for viewing this session. Next session, I will take a two-span slab culvert with return type wing wall. Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you.